No, I don't waste no time.
What's going on, guys, and welcome to a new video. Now, for those of you that are new to the channel and don't know who I am, my name is Joshua Daniel George. I own a social media marketing agency called Brandpreneur here in the Netherlands. It's a six-figure agency, and we basically take on clients and help them, you know, get more business by leveraging social media marketing, Facebook ads, social media advertising, media buying, and so on and so forth. Now, alongside that, I also have my own coaching business where I basically teach you guys how to do the same. So I basically take you guys on as a personal client and help you guys, you know, get started with your own agency, help you get clients, and also help you get results. Now, with that said, I want to basically spend this video on my strategy on closing clients, and I just want to briefly mention the dynamic when approaching clients or when going into meetings, because it is different depending on the situation. So let me just quickly clarify that. When you are getting clients from platforms like freelancer.com, guru.com, upwork.com, peopleperhour.com, bark.com, and so on and so forth, basically they are looking for a social media marketer, okay? They place a job post on those freelancer websites, mentioning that they are in need of someone to manage their pages, someone to help with their Facebook ads, someone to help with their Google ads, someone to help with getting more sales for their online webshop, etc. Okay, you then apply for that job, or you know, you figure out who the owner of the job post is and then reach out to that person and try and get them on a call. Okay, now if you do that, they are already at that point where they know what social media marketing is, they know they need it, and they're already, you know, actively seeking someone to take, you know, on that particular job or project. Okay, so when you get them on a call, it's actually okay to try and get the one call close. Okay, so what I mean by that is basically, you know, get them to agree to work with you in call number one. Okay, so it's not necessarily a discovery call or a consultation call, it's literally the closing call. Okay, so what you do is you briefly, you know, ask them a few questions about their business, where they're at, you know, what they need help with, and then you explain what you can do for them, you agree upon a price, and then you move forward from there. Okay, always, quick tip also, because I've basically failed with this so many times in the past, always get them to confirm that they want to work with you on that call, and if possible, also just send over the invoice, okay? So you know that they've received it, and your best case scenario is that they already pay it on the call, okay? So make sure that you exchange payment details and you know, basically get that confirmation and commitment from them during that call, okay? So that basically only works with freelancer websites, or if you have some kind of funnel in place where they reach out to you to hop on a call. Okay, so let's say you've got a webinar, or you've got some kind of advertisement where they can schedule a call to take over, for you to take over their advertisements or their social media management, okay? If it's a call like that, again, you can go for the one call close. However, if it's just a brief, you know, consultation, or if you have Facebook ads set up, like lead generation ads, where you offer a free consultation call, a complimentary strategy session, or anything like that, then you can't really go for the one call close. And I recommend the two call close, where basically you basically treat the first call like a discovery call, where you guys get to know each other. And you mentioned that you're just seeing if it's a right fit, you want to, you know, get to know who that person is, and vice versa, introduce yourself. But basically that first call is to warm the client up, okay? Get that client interested enough to commit to working together, okay? And that is basically what that first call will be, is getting that client to commit to either a second call or get them committed to working together right there and then, okay? So what I usually do in this scenario, you know, where it is a client that has come through a, you know, our lead funnel, where we offer a complimentary consultation, which is basically just a discovery call to figure out who it is and to get them pre-framed, you know, enough or qualified enough to actually, you know, basically, you know, send their money over, and then we can get started and, you know, start getting them results. situations like that, I, like I said, basically go through the same flow as I usually would. I ask them questions, where they're at with the business, what forms of marketing they're currently doing now, and try and figure out, without directly asking them, how much budget they've got to spend on Facebook ads, and if they can afford my retainer. If I feel that they can afford my retainer and they have got the budget and I can actually get results for them, because that's important as well, guys. There's no point in taking on a client, spending time and effort on it just to get that first retainer, knowing fully well that you're going to lose that client 1 month later. But back to the point of this video, once you've done all that, and you know and you're confident that you can get results for them and that they can afford your retainer or your fee for that service, then you get them to commit and confirm that they want it. And like I say, commit to getting that, like, they know in call number one what your fee is, and you've got a verbal agreement that they can do that, they are fine with that, they're okay with that. Then what you do is you schedule a second call no later than 48 hours after the first call to basically confirm everything and get them sort of onboarded, okay? In between those two calls, you send them a breakdown of what you're gonna do for them, okay? It's very, very important that you call this a breakdown and not a proposal. Why? Because a proposal gives them the impression that they've still got the option to back out, and that is what you want to avoid, okay? You want to avoid getting people on a discovery call, spending half an hour or 45 minutes of your time on someone that is going to disappear off the face of the earth after they put the phone down, okay? So what you do, sometimes they'll actually just say, okay, this sounds good, can you send me a proposal of everything you can do on email, and then we can move forward from there. Then what you say is, okay, we don't really send proposals. There's nothing that we can say in a proposal that I can't just say to you now on the phone. So if you are happy to work together, if I have answered all your questions, if I have earned your business, then what I'll do is I'll send a breakdown of everything that we're going to be doing for you. If you're happy with that, basically that breakdown is actually a proposal, but we don't call it a proposal. It's just, we call it a breakdown because it sounds more official. That we're actually going to be working together, okay? So you say, I'll send you a breakdown of everything we're going to be doing for you. If you're happy with that, I'll send the contract after it and the invoice, and as soon as we get the money out of the way, we can focus on what is important, which is getting you results, okay? What this will ensure is that, they basically have made that commitment, because they make that commitment on call number one, that they're going to be working together. You send the proposal, which what we call a breakdown, to them via email. It's basically a work document of everything that you're going to be doing, social media marketing. You basically, you beef up everything you're going to be doing, social media marketing, Facebook ads, Facebook strategy, split testing, audience testing, different types of funnels, and so on and so forth, okay? If they say they're happy with that, then you send over the contract, which says everything that you're basically going to be doing for them, how long it's for, what your retainer is. And what I usually do is add that breakdown as like an annex below the contract. You send that over and then you send the invoice, or you get their credit card details so you can add them on Stripe, and then you can basically set up a subscription there, because we don't want to be sending invoices every single month, because basically every time you send an invoice, they're going to remember that they're paying you, and then they need to basically put effort in to actually pay your service. Whereas every single time they recall that invoice, they see that invoice, they're going to basically think to themselves, is it worth it? Okay, and that is what we want to prevent. We want it to be automatic, so that without their effort, it basically goes out of their account and into yours, into either your Stripe, your PayPal, or whatever, okay? So that way, they don't actually have to do anything to pay you, and they actually have to put effort in to cancel that subscription or cancel that automatic payment, okay? That is basically the point where you wanna get to, just to make it easier and just to ensure that you're actually going to be paid on time, okay? Once you've done that, then you can start the onboarding process, which is an entirely different beast on its own, but we'll get into that into future videos. But that is basically how I close clients, and I need to say we nowadays, because there's actually more of us now with Brandpreneur, but that is how we close clients, okay? So like I said, if it's a freelancer type of job and they are ready to go, then you can close them on the first call. If it's someone who is interested and basically just want to book a discovery call with you, or if you do cold outreach, so you actually get them on a call by reaching out yourself, then you will need to do it in two parts, maybe even three parts, depending on how big the client is and how many people in their
need to agree with you guys working together.
Okay, so anyway, that is all I've got for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you need help with your agency, or if you, you know, basically need someone to help you get started with everything and get everything up and running, like I said, I do offer coaching. If you are ready to get started and you want me to take you on as a personal client, it is linked in the description box down below, so you can get signed up there and I will get you onboarded. If you are on the fence about that and you just want a quick, no strings attached chat about it, then I also have a free discovery call. It's all linked in the description box down below. Like this video if you got something out of it. Subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys in the next one.